666, again a very short topic, probably 10 minutes or so. 666, lot of search going on for this number 666 for about the last 1900 years, and Holy Spirit has revealed how to understand 666. Finding the word is one thing, but having the right approach is the most important thing, because if you take the wrong road, the answer will be wrong. 666, what is 666? Let's read this verse, Revelation 13:18. Let's read this verse, Revelation 13:18.
Here is wisdom. Let him who has understanding calculate the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. His number is 666.
Okay, let's look at the phrases which are highlighted here. Number of the beast. It's called as number of the beast and number of a man. It should be the number of a man. So there has to be a reference to a man here. A reference to a man has to come. And these days there are a lot of wrong answers coming in. People say that computer, it refers to 666. Computer, is it referring to a man? The word computer, does it refer to a man? No. So this has to have a reference to a man here. A man's name has to come. And it is also having another reference here. Let's take a look at Revelation 14:11. Let's read this verse. Revelation 14:11.
And the smoke of their torment ascends forever and ever, and they have no rest day or night, who worship the beast and his image, and whoever receives the mark of his name.
Here it's called as mark of his name. In Revelation 14:11, it's called as mark of a name, and in Revelation 13:18, it says it is the number of the beast and it is the number of a man. And if you calculate this number, it is 666. Let's identify the right approach. Since the time of Irenaeus, he is a disciple of Polycarp. Polycarp is the disciple of Apostle John. He died in 202. He himself predicted a number, predicted a particular name, which actually you can summarize those 666. And right from that time, a big search has been happening in Christendom, isn't it? And let's find out the right approach to understand this. Number of a man. As the number of a man must necessarily imply the name of a man. It's not just the number alone, because many times we focus on the number alone. It has to also have the name of a man. It can't be computer. Computer is not a man. And it has to have a reference to the name of a man, the number of the name of a man. It should have a name of a man, and if you can do a calculation, it has to have the number of a man, which is 666. But in which language should I look for the number? There are a few rules to follow. And what are the rules to follow? New Testament and Revelation is written in Greek. So you'll have to remove all the English words or any other language words except for Greek. So the only language we'll have to use is Greek here. It is written in Greek, you'll have to use a Greek word. Second is, the word has to have a reference to a man. It can't have a reference to a computer or something else, an object. It should reference a man. And the third rule is, when you do the calculation, you should be able to derive the number 666. These are the three rules we need to follow. These are biblical rules. New Testament Revelation is written in Greek, so we should use only Greek words. Second is, it should refer to a man. Can't be a computer or any other non-living thing. And its number has to be 666. Let's look at this name, Latinos. Latinos, it's a Greek name. It's a Greek word. Does it follow all the three different rules? Latinos, it is a Greek word. Name of a man. Is it referring to the name of a man? Yes. The English translation is Latin man. The English translation is Latin man. And can we get 666 from this name? Yes. In computation, we get 666. How do we get 666? I personally verified it. Greek alphabets used as numerals. You can go to this table, have a look at the Greek alphabets, find out the alpha, beta, gamma stuff, all the Greek alphabets, find out what alphabet has what value, calculate it for yourself. L for lambda, A for alpha, T for tau, E for epsilon, I for iota, N for nu, O for omicron, S for sigma, and you get 666 here. Does it follow all the three rules. First rule is it a Greek word? Yes, it is a Greek word. Does it refer to a man? Yes, it refers to a Latin man. We'll have a description about who the Latin man is. And the third one, in computation, do we get 666? Yes, we get 666. And it is not my own discovery. Irenaeus, as we had seen before, he was a disciple of Polycarp. Polycarp is a disciple of Apostle John. And this word, it passed down through the ages through this person called as Irenaeus. We still have the old writings of Irenaeus. And let's look at the Latin man and the significance or maybe the insignificance of Latin. Latin is the official language of the unholy see, Vatican. Vatican, they call themselves as Holy See. It is actually the unholy see. And it is the language used only in the 110 acres in Vatican City alone. The Vatican uses Latin in all its official documents. And if a priest has to do a postgraduate degree in Vatican, he has to do it in Latin language. The Catholic Mass was conducted in Latin until 1965. So if you've got a 70-year-old person in your home, and if he was an ex-Catholic or maybe he is currently a Catholic, he would have definitely attended the Mass in Latin. So for many centuries, the Mass was conducted only in Latin, even in India. In all languages, in every country, the Catholic Mass was conducted in Latin. And in the pontifical universities, if someone wants to do a postgraduate course, it has to be in Latin even till date. Vatican City is the home to the world's only ATM in Latin. And Vatican Radio is in Latin, Vatican Television is in Latin. So the Latin, it always refers to Vatican City. Vatican City means the leader is Pope. Who is the Latin man? Who is the leader of all the Latin-speaking people? It is the Pope. It is the beast, the second beast, the Roman Catholic leader. Pope is the Latin man. Pope is the Latinos. And the proper and the appellative name, Latinos, is in every way applicable to this guy, Pope. He is the beast and he is the 666. He has got the mark. It's not anything else. If you have lots of other names, let me give you all the other names. Antichrist will throw a lot of things to divert you, isn't it? There is a lot of diversion tactic used by the Antichrist. Words like apostates, words like tradition, words like Italian church, the Latin kingdom would still result in 666, but it is not in a Greek language. We'll have to throw these words out. And it's not the name of a man. It has to refer to a name of a man. Romith, Roman kingdom. It refers to 666. Romiti, Roman man. It refers to 666, but this is in Hebrew language. But since Revelation is written in Greek, we should reject these Hebrew languages. And Vicarius Filii, interestingly, it refers to the Pope. Vicarius Filii in Latin, it refers to Vicar of Christ, who is none other than the Pope. It results in 666. It is a tempting one, but still it has to be thrown out. It's a tempting one. It still refers to the Pope, but it is not in Greek. It's not in Greek. You still have to reject this word. Any other word, a Hebrew word you'll have to reject, an English word you'll have to reject, a Latin word you'll have to reject, and if a word is a Greek word, and if the word is still not referring to a man, you'll still have to reject it. So it has to be a Greek word, and it has to have a 666 computation, and it should refer to a man. And this word is lying in the manuscripts for the last 1800 years. You simply have to dig it out. With the help of the Holy Spirit, we'll have to dig it out. Holy Spirit will lead you to the right place. If you ask humbly, Jeremiah 33:3, if you ask, he is ready to give it to us. So this word, Latinos, was actually given to us by this person, Irenaeus. Irenaeus, who died in 202, he wrote this down and he said that it'll be from the Latin-speaking population. The Antichrist will come from the Latin-speaking population. So Pope is the Latinos, the Latin man. He is the 666. And anyone who is obeying the Pope, they've got the mark of the beast. We should also understand what the mark of the beast is. So with this, we complete the 666 topic.